What is that? Amen. God is good. Well, let's stand. And we're going to get ready to go before the Lord in prayer and offering. I do want to say next week, well, within the next couple of weeks, if you could, let's give it a couple of weeks. I know I was talking to Brother Angelo there in South Africa. And they don't have some of the same amenities we do here. And I just kind of felt led and wanted to help them out. See, right now is their summertime. So our winter is their summer. And so in his house, when it's hot, it's hot. When it's cold, it's cold. You know, now their cold isn't like our cold either, but they still get a little chilly. But they don't have air conditioning. They don't have any of those type of things. Even just having a fan is a luxury. And I said, well, I told them to find out how much the fans are, you know, so we can at least purchase them some fans. Amen. So I want to do that. I like just, you know, maybe next week, within the next couple of weeks, if you just sow a special offering or something towards that. I think when I was looking it up, it was, I mean, just the fans are kind of, well, more expensive than it would be here. The type of fans that they have is like $125 for a fan, you know, where we pay $20 just for a box fan. So, but I think their fans are almost kind of, it's not air conditioning, but it's got something where you can put like water in at least to try to cool them down. But I didn't think that bad. I'd like to get on about four or five of them, actually. I think that'd be nice where they can have one and, you know, three or four bedrooms. And then also like their parents, his parents is in the back, have like this in-law quarters, mother-in-law quarters, I don't know, house, I can't say mother-in-law, it's his parents, parents' quarters in the back. I think it'd be nice if they can have one for theirs too, amen? So if you'll join me with that, you know, I'd really like to be able to do that. You know, I think it'd just be a blessing for them, amen? You know, we're part of the body of Christ and we're here to help one another, yes? Yes? Yes and amen. All right. Well, let's go before the Lord in prayer and take our offering in our right hand. Lord God, we just thank you and praise you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord, hallelujah, for all that you do. We thank you for allowing us to be here today. Thank you, Lord God, hallelujah, for your blessings and your mercy and your grace. We just love you, Lord. We appreciate you. We ask that you just come by today, Lord God, and continue to help us, Lord, help your people. Lord, we just bring an offering, a seed unto you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, for the body of Christ. We thank you, Lord, for the faithfulness of giving, Lord God. We thank you for even having a giving heart, Lord God. Lord, you said you give seed to the sower, Lord God, and you ask you to just continue to bless your people. And we thank you, Lord, and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. We have some people, I think, it's kind of like in need or something, too. Brother Jay, you still off work? Brother Jay, you still off work? Amen. Amen. Didn't y'all just refinance on your home or something like that? Amen, amen. Y'all got y'all first payment coming up, huh? Amen. You've been working extra trying to. Amen. Y'all good? You sure? Okay, well, I tell you what, we're going to bless y'all anyway. How about that? You know, we're going to bless y'all anyway. How about that? Amen. Because you, I know you off work and stuff too. So, amen. So, we're going to bless y'all anyway. Okay. So, I wrote a check already. So, we put it in your wife's name. We thought she took care of the finances. Is that okay? Okay. Amen. So make sure you see me so I can get that to you. Okay. Amen. Anybody, we got any other needs? Anybody else in need that we don't know about? Brother Joe, you say you in need? Brother Joe said, hey, is he feeling good? Hey, we're the body of Christ. We're supposed to take care of one another. Amen. You know, I don't even say that even bragging. You know, a lot of times, but you know, a lot of times people look at the church, like we just take money, and we don't ever bless. You know, we're here for God's people. This is a storehouse. This is a storehouse, and this is just what you do. Amen. And you help your people, and you help God's people, and you help the people of God everywhere. Amen. I think that's it. All right. You guys gonna, here, I think I left my office door unlocked, and you can just put it in my office. Or no, better yet, here, let me just give you the business office key. Huh? You do got to turn into the show. Yeah. Amen. Yes, ma'am. So I think we have our children that's going to dance today. Amen. All right. Sister Charity, does this need to be moved or is this good? It's good? Okay. Amen.
Continuing of your hands, lift up your hands, open up your mouth. God, we give you glory. We praise your name.
Let praises rise from the inside, from the inside of me. May you delight in the inside. In the inside of me, come fill my life from the inside, from the inside of me. Set me on fire from the inside.
Anybody want that?
From the inside of me, 'cause all
somebody let your praise rise
from the inside, from the inside of me. May you delight in the inside. I want you to be pleased with me, Lord. In the inside of me, come feel.
From the inside.
we'll sing. Oh Lord, he is for you, to be glorified. Lift up your name. We lift up your name, Lord. All I want is for you.
Can you lift those hands right there?
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, put those hands together. Good job, good job, good job. Hallelujah. Amen. You got to train them up, train them up. Amen. I think we got one more team coming to dance, too, while they kind of getting ready.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Might as well loosen the dance a little bit in between, huh?
Jesus,
Jesus,
be
events. All around me,
I'm asking you to protect me.
As I travel on the way,
I know we can.
I know you can.
Yes, Lord,
I know you will.
Yes, Lord,
fight my battle.
Yes, Lord,
keep my feet still.
Yes, Lord, the events all around me,
I don't know what's wrong with y'all today. Y'all just tired today. Somebody just put those hands together and act like y'all want to worship the Lord today. We're going
to
make y'all praise him today.
I'm asking you to
protect me as I travel along the way.
I know you can. I know you will. Fight my battles if I just keep still. Say,
it's all around me every day.
Yay.
This is my prayer, Lord.
Sing, Darian. Sing, girl. I see you singing.
Every day that you would guide my footsteps, let the stumble is paid. Lord,
Let's put those hands together one more time. Amen. All right. So are they starting from the back or the front? Okay, amen. They can come on up there. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I want to thank God one for all the visitors that are here today, which really not visitors, are just family. Amen. Amen. Seeds of praise. Okay, yes. Thank you. Thank God for the seeds of praise. Amen. Amen. So we'll turn it over to them. Amen. Go ahead.
Come on, it's a song of intercession. All of these songs we keep singing, all of this praise we keep bringing, yeah. When it's all said and done, yeah, we just want you to come. Hey! These hands we keep raising, these prayers we keep praying, when it's all said and done, we just want you to come. So here's our prayer, Lord. Let it fall. Just longing for you.
Amen. Come on, let it fall, let it fall. Come on, come on, come on, come on. I like that, I like it. RJ, come here. Come on, show me that move again. Come on, show me that move. Come on, show me that move again. Do that really. Come on. I like it, I like it. Come on, I can do that. Run it back, run it back, run it back, run it back, run it back. Run it back, I can do that. Come on. I like it because you're manly with it too. I like that. I like that. You can be manly with it. They said you gotta take it back. Take it back some more. How many can move in here? Y'all gotta move a little bit. Come on, y'all gonna move today. I don't know what's wrong. Come on, let's move. Come on, Kimora, I like it.
We're moving out the way. All we want is you. Say, move how you wanna do what you wanna do. We're moving out the way. All we want is you. Move how you wanna move.
Come on.
Do what you wanna
do. I like it, I like it. Remix. That was the remix. I just put them on the spot, made them do it all over again. Amen, amen. That kind of took me back a little bit when they was moving like that. I was like, okay, okay. I think I can move like that. Amen. It took me back to my days a little bit. Amen. God is good. God is good. Yeah, everybody's hot now, huh? Amen. At this time, I'm going to move out of the way. Thank God we have a great speaker here today. Great minister of God, Minister Laquisha Glasco. Amen. From Judah Life, Destiny Church. Come on, let's stand to our feet and welcome her as she come. And just have your way. Preach the word.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. He's too good to sit on him. He's done too much not to give him the praise, the glory, and the honor. I truly acknowledge the King of Kings, the head of my life, my Father, and his name is Jesus. Hallelujah. How can you say that name and not have a reaction? Because that was the name that kept me. That was the name in the midnight hour when I didn't know what to do. That was the name when I was sick and I called out unto him. Hallelujah. He delivered me, and I truly give him thanks. I thank the Lord so much just to be here. I was telling Pastor Ash, this is like my second home. We watch you guys a lot on the stream when we're not able to make it. And I'm so thankful for those from Judah Life that came. Definitely want to give honor to Pastor Ash and Lady Ash. Please give honor to your pastor and first lady. They are so sweet and they do so much, things that we would never know. So we definitely honor them. And, of course, my pastor, Pastor Wendy Berry Sr. and Lady Dinetta Berry, we give honor to them from the Judah Life family. I won't be before you long, but if you would please take out your word. I'm going to be coming from Mark chapter 2, and I'm going to read verses 1 through 5 and then skip down to 11 through 12. Thank you so much. And I'm not sure if this is your custom here, but if we could stand for the word of God, I really like to honor his word. And if someone doesn't have a Bible, share. Share the word with somebody next to you. Again, that's Mark chapter 2, verses 1 through 5 and 11 and 12. And it reads, "And again he entered into Capernaum. After some days, and it was noised that he was in the house. And straightway many were gathered together, insomuch that there was no room to receive them. No, not so much as about the door. And he preached the word unto them. And they come unto him, bringing one sick of the palsy, which was born of four. And when they could not come nigh unto him for the press, they uncovered the roof where he was. And when they had broken it up, they let down the bed wherein the sick of the palsy lay. When Jesus saw their faith, he said unto the sick of the palsy, Son, thy sins be forgiven thee. Going down to 11, I say unto thee, arise and take up thy bed and go thy way into thine house. And immediately he arose, took up the bed, and went forth before them all, insomuch that they were all amazed, and they glorified God, saying, We never saw it on this fashion. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. When I read this, immediately we see that it said it was noised that he was in the house. And when something is noised, there's a loud outcry. There's a commotion. And many of us from reading the word know that there was always a bunch of crowds following Jesus. And as a result, the word says in straightway or immediately, a lot of people begin to gather together in this house. And if you can just picture it, the word said there were so many people in this house, you couldn't even get through the front door. And when I read this, I began to think of churches back in time. I'm one of those people, I love that they preserved history. And on YouTube, you can look up old services. And there were so many people in the house of the Lord. And I might be overcalculating, but sometimes it looked like thousands of people were there just to see Jesus and just to get the word from them. Because while they were in this house, it said Jesus was preaching the word unto them. And I said, man, God, people were so hungry for the Lord. They were so hungry for your word. And so when we get to verse 3, here we see that we have four individuals who come carrying a man while he is in the bed. And he's sick with this palsy. And obviously his condition is so great to the point where he couldn't walk for himself. But he needed some people that was able to carry him to Jesus. And despite his condition, him and his friends, or the four, were determined to get him there. And I began to think, sometimes you need some people that's going to carry you when you're in your condition. Carry you in prayer, carry you with support, and even just being present. Hallelujah. Because when you carry someone, you don't give attention to their condition, whatever it may be, but you place your faith in Jesus that he will see them through according to his holy word. But these four individuals, they're trying to get near to Jesus. The Bible says they try to come nigh unto him, come close, but they couldn't, again, because there were so many people just thronging towards the Lord. And right at this moment, I begin to think, We don't know anyone's name. We only know there's one man in a bed sick with palsy. We know there's four people carrying him. We don't know how far they've come. We don't know what these people have been through. We don't know their story. They could have left this man in the bed right where there was crowds of people. They could have given up on him. They weren't worried about who was around. They weren't worried about the fact they couldn't get in the traditional way through the door, through the back, through the side. But they're focused on, we got to get our friend to Jesus. They made no excuse. They made no excuse. And in the Bible, I got excited when I read this part because I would have never thought of this. They uncovered the roof. They uncovered the roof. And it said not only did they uncover it, they had to break it up just to drop this man down there at the feet of Jesus. Now I said, now wait a minute. Can you imagine being in this house and you start feeling material falling from the roof and you don't know where it's coming from? And they begin to create some kind of opening just so they can drop this man right at Jesus' feet. Yeah. Whew, Jesus. Woo. I ain't even giving my title. I just realized that. But once they dropped him in, Jesus saw their faith. He didn't just see the man in the bed. Right. He saw all four of the men, or all four of the individuals, we don't know. He saw the man in that bed. He saw their faith. Yeah. But there was one he spoke to. And it said to the man with palsy, and it got me excited, son, he called him a son. It's a blessing to be a son. Thy sins be forgiven thee. Now, I said, Lord, you could have said, you know, son, by faith you are healed. He could have focused on his healing. He could have focused on anything dealing with the condition. But when you're dealing with Jesus, he don't see your condition necessarily. He sees salvation. Hallelujah. So there was many people around. They were expecting this man to be physically healed, which indeed he was, if you've read this text before, of his sickness. And we will get there. But in this moment, it wasn't so much about his physical condition. See, this man went to be healed of palsy, but left forgiven. Come on. Don't play with it. He went to Jesus because of his condition, but the Lord, he didn't say you are healed. He said your sins have been forgiven. So once he came for the healing, but he healed the relationship that he had with him. See, some of y'all may not understand, so I'm going to take my time. See, we go to the Lord for a lot of things, and it's okay to petition God for things. It's okay. He wants us to have faith that he can do anything. But in that moment, he wanted to be in a condition where he could get up out of that bed and where he could walk. But the Lord's like, I got something better for you. I want to restore you back to me, and I want to heal you of your sin so that you get more than just your healing, but there's a restoration that you get with me. Because I know you know I can heal, but I want to forgive you so I can put you in a place where your relationship with me is stronger than it was when you came in this house. He said, let me address your sins first, then I'll heal your body. Hallelujah, because he's more concerned with the sin than the sickness. That's why you got to keep Jesus first. No matter the season, I'm going to say this, that's why you got to keep Jesus first. Because Jesus, he's concerned about your needs. He is concerned about your need, but he's more concerned about your soul. He's more concerned about your position with him. He can bless us with money. He can bless us with cars and houses and heal our body in the hospital. He can do those things, but what is your relationship like with him? That's what he cares about the most. Whew. And if I had the time, I would address verses 6 through 9 that deals with the scribes. But long story short, many of us who've read about the scribes, Pharisees, Sadducees, they struggled to or rejected to understand or receive who Jesus was. He wasn't just some man. Amen. But you will miss the Lord when you don't take the time to know him for yourself. And I will just leave it at that with the scribes. But when we get to 11 and 12, it says, I say unto thee, arise and take up thy bed and go thy way into thine house. And immediately he rose, took up that bed, and went forth before them all, insomuch that they were all amazed and glorified God, saying, we never saw it on this fashion. When the people even themselves have said they have never seen it in this fashion, in this order, right? Because they were expecting God, Jesus to come in the way that they and their mind could contain him. They wanted him to heal first, then forgive. But even the scribes were struggling because they're like, only God can forgive men of sins. But they, again, they didn't understand. They didn't understand, but we're still praying for those who may not understand. But what I got out of this text is the real miracle was not the fact that he was able to get up, not the fact that he was able to rise, but the real miracle was that he was forgiven of his sins. Oh, Jesus, I'm sorry. Hallelujah. Because if you've done some stuff and you've been forgiven, then you have an appreciation that you know it was only Jesus that was able to wipe your record clean, that was able to cover your reputation so that people don't see you like you used to be. We don't know what this man had went through. We don't know how he got to this bed because we're dealing with a sickness condition, but all of us had a condition. All of us had a condition. And it was only Jesus who was able to meet us in the midst of that condition so that we can arise from the dead and walk again. Hallelujah. Yes, we know this man was able to walk. Yes, we know he was healed of his condition. But again, he walked away forgiven of his sins. And the Bible says again, he immediately arose. He had faith that he was healed. See, when the Lord told him, arise, sometimes people question it. They start doubting. They're like, he didn't give an excuse. He could have been like, Lord, but I've been in this bed for years. I mean, my condition, am I able to get up? You said I could walk. Can I really walk? But he just arose. And he took that bed up. I bet you he was looking at everybody in the house like, I got in. There was no doubt that he could do what Jesus said he can do. And this man and those that carried him, they were desperate for Jesus. He didn't leave that house the same way he came in. And that was the biggest thing that I got out of that text. He came in, he couldn't walk, he was sick, he left out healed and forgiven. Yes, he came for what he wanted, but he got what he needed. Thank you, Lord. He was desperate for the Lord. You can praise him. I'm not an interactive person, but I do believe, don't hold your praise from the Lord, because we never know what each person, you know, how the word is dealing with each person in the congregation. And when you're desperate, your condition doesn't matter. When you're desperate, you desire food physically more than you do naturally. When you're desperate, you begin to fast because you understand the importance of killing this flesh. When you're desperate, you don't make excuses. You pray for a solution. Hallelujah. When you're desperate, hallelujah, you begin to pray instead of worry. Pray instead of doubt. Pray instead of fuss. You begin to call on Jesus because you know it's only because of him who holds all answers, who hold everything. Hallelujah. When you're desperate, you begin to study the word in such a way that you begin to find out that there's some versions that omit the word of God out of it. If you don't believe me, Matthew 17:21 is missing from the NIV. Whatever I need to do. Oh, Jesus. I don't apologize, but I do say, excuse me. Because the Lord, he was dealing with me. And my title is, how desperate are you? We chase after so much stuff. We need so much. And yet we have a sovereign God who was calling out unto his children. And he's saying, all you need is me. But how desperate do you want me? This man had a sickness. He broke through that roof. But he didn't do it alone. And that's why we need one another. Because he had help to get him to Jesus. Oh, Jesus. When you're desperate, you do anything you need to do to get what you need to get.
And a lot of us know what that means. Some of us who've tried the world, unfortunately, we know what desperation looks like, because by any means necessary, we did what we needed to do to get what we wanted, and it was about us. But when you come into the house of the Lord, it's different. Your desperation is Jesus. What you're thirsty for comes from him. And I'm so grateful. Hallelujah. Do we have anybody who's thirsty, who's desperate for the Lord? And what God showed me, desperation has a sound. It has a sound in your praise. And your praise begins to produce a sound that's pleasing unto the Lord. And he begins to hear that desperation, that cry, hallelujah, whatever you need to do. He begins to see what you're doing. I see you praying about it, but are your actions contradicting what you believe I can do? He's watching. He's listening. And when you begin to praise the Lord, hallelujah, some of you are going to get it because you're going to start praising him. I don't know what you need, but when you start to praise the Lord as a desperation, that starts to happen, and then you begin to cry out, Jesus, hallelujah. Then you get into a position with him where you humble yourself, and now you're right where he needs you to be. And then you begin to call out your family members' names, call out your children, call out this world, this nation. God, only you can heal our land. God, only you can do the things that you do. And then you begin to lower yourself just a little bit lower than every problem that you cried out unto him for. And then you get into a posture of prayer, and then you begin to labor before the Lord. And as you're laboring, he's fighting behind you. As you're laboring, angels are encamped all around about you. As you're laboring, the Lord is giving you promises, reminding you of what he said. As you're laboring, the stress begins to leave right there at his feet. Oh God, the confusion, the doubt begins to lay right there. And then when you get up and you rise up, hallelujah, you begin to give him thanks because he's done it. Woo, hallelujah. Some of you in the late midnight hour know what it's like when you are petitioning the Lord for something, when you don't understand, God, why is this happening? When you don't understand, Lord, what am I supposed to do? God is telling me to tell you, you need to get desperate for me. Because when you're desperate for me, there's no room for anything else. You don't lack anything. I got you. Shut up, I'll see ya. Ooh, when you're desperate for the Lord. Ooh, when you're desperate for the Lord, he positions you to get back in your position. Some of us have lost our focus. Some of us have lost our way, but he's still working with you. He don't just throw us away. He uses where we are still for his glory, Jesus. And we thank him, hallelujah, for everything that he does. So my question, how desperate are you today? And be honest with yourself. What is it that is more important than the Lord? What is it that you need to sacrifice so that you can get to Jesus by any means necessary? What is it that is more important than him? What is it that you just can't give up? What is it? He is crying for us, and we're not even crying for him. When you're desperate, all you see is Jesus. You don't see the problem. You don't see the condition. You don't see the people. This man, he didn't care about none of them people. Not that he didn't care about them, but his aim, he wasn't focused on what everybody was saying. They probably thought this man was crazy. Like, where are you taking this man in this bed? He wasn't worried about the critics. He wasn't worried about what people were saying. None of that. I need to be at Jesus' feet at any means necessary. God wants us to be longing for him. We should be excited every day that he gives us another day with breath in our body. We should be excited, and we should cry out unto him like never before. We have the answer to this season, but we got to be in position. We got to want him more than anything. Because when we don't, our focus is wrong. The Lord wants us to have a desperate spirit on this morning. And as I close, whatever it is, we don't know what one another goes through. And the good thing is, we serve a God who knows all things, so we don't need to know. All I need to know is the who, not the what. So I know that even if my brother and my sister don't tell me what they're going through, I know I can go to my Father because he knows every name. He knows every issue. And I can petition him and I can say, Lord, touch them. Touch them. But the Lord is calling us to do more. Not to be lackluster. Not to sit on him. Not to undermine his way and his word. He is calling us to seek him like never before. If you got to take your word to work and every now and then get some scripture in you, then do it. If you got to turn that TV off with your children so that they can read together with you in your living room, then do it. If you got to give something up and you've been struggling with it, then do it. This is not the season to play with the Lord. It never was a season to play with the Lord. But this is the season to go after Jesus like never before. It don't matter your age. Notice, even though he had help and Jesus saw their faith, it was him who he spoke to. So some people can carry you in prayer, but it's up to you to drink from the well. It's up to you to know Jesus for yourself. People can only pray and carry you for so long before you got to make a decision. Hallelujah, that I want Jesus and nothing else. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, hallelujah. If we can stand on our feet. Jesus. Jesus. You can praise him. There's some people. If you need to let it out, don't hold your praise in. Only you know, you and God know what it is you need from him. Only he knows where you stand with him in relationship. But just like that man, he says, son, thy sins are forgiven thee. Now that doesn't give you an out to feel like, okay, Lord, I can do what I want and you're going to forgive me. That's not necessarily the case. He would rather you just do what's right so that you can stay in his arms. So if you could just take a few moments and worship the Lord in your own way. If you need to cry, whatever you need to do, just like that man, he wasn't worried about his surroundings. Hallelujah. He wasn't worried about who was around. It's me and you, Lord. I've been struggling with this. I need you to deliver me. I haven't been praying like I should. I need you to restore me. My heart ain't been right. I've been thinking some crazy thoughts. But I know you're able, Jesus. God, I haven't been in prayer enough. But I know that you're calling me back, Jesus. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Shout out, Bosia. Woo, Lord, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. See, as you're speaking to him, that's that sound. That's that sound I was talking about. A sound of people of faith. A sound of people that's hungry for him. A sound of people that says, Lord, I'm not going back. A sound that's saying, Lord, I'm staying right here till you clean me. I'm staying right here till you make me new. I'm staying right here till I stop doing what I'm not supposed to do. I'm staying right here, Jesus, until I give you everything. I'm staying right here in this place of surrender. I won't move until you say move. I won't speak until you say speak. Jesus, I'm staying right here with you. I will be still and know that you are God. This season will not dictate who you are to me. I won't doubt you. You've worked too many miracles for me to do so. I've seen you work. I've heard the testimony. I've seen you in my own life. I won't give up on you, Jesus, because you haven't given up on me. From the oldest to the youngest, Jesus, you continue to bless us. You continue to cover us with your mighty and strong name. You continue, oh God, with the blood to cover us. Even when we wasn't in your presence, God, you covered your people for this very moment. It's not by accident that you are in the house of the Lord. He honors every sacrifice. He honors every person that has made it up in their heart, in their mind, that I won't let nothing stop me from getting to Jesus. Not a virus. Woo! And we got to say it, but nothing will keep me from getting in your presence. There's been too many people who was even in the prison cell. I'm still going to bless you, Jesus. In everything, I will give you thanks. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I feel some people putting the Lord back on the throne of their hearts. I feel the Lord. Hallelujah. I feel him positioning some people back in place. I feel some people putting the men back in place. I feel some people putting the women back in place. That just like that man, when you leave this house, you won't be the same. He left with more than he bargained for. Jesus, I came here to see you for this, but you gave me so much more. Telling you now, if you want to praise him, this is the perfect time. Don't worry about how loud you are. Don't worry about who's watching. It's just you and Jesus. There's two or three gathered together in here. He is in the midst. You don't want to miss him questioning like the scribes. You don't want to miss him doubting like the scribes. But he's in this place. He knows your pain. He knows your burden. He knows what you're going through. And just like with Sarah, he asked her, is there anything too hard for me? You limit me because of your mindset. You limit me because of your lack of faith. It's not that I can't do it, but do you believe that I can? Woo.
Give me you.
Hallelujah.
Everything else.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Give me you.
Hallelujah. How many is desperate this morning? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good word. Good word. It's good God of praise. Hallelujah. Good word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Said he saw their faith, but he spoke to one. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I got some people I want to see God save and deliver and set free. Not only that, I want to also be the one he speaks to. Hallelujah. Amen. I received that word. I think it just ties right on along. Hallelujah. How many need him today? We need him. We need him. It's so easy to be distracted. So easily to be distracted by so many things. And we need that desperation for God again. Amen. Let us stand. Let us stand. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Minister Laquisha. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Good to see everyone here. We appreciate you coming out today. Let's take care of ourselves, take care of our bodies. Let's remember those who are sick. We have quite a few who wasn't feeling well today and even earlier this week. Amen. We'll continue to take care of ourselves. I know there were some who had tested positive, but God is a keeper and a healer. We thank God we got some people with just the flu. You know, just because somebody gets sick don't mean it's the virus. Amen. Amen. There's other sicknesses going on besides just the virus. But God is a healer and a keeper through it all. Amen. And so we pray for those that are sick and those that are down in their body. And we just continue to come together as a people. Amen. Take care of yourself. Let's continue to lift one another up. Thank you, Judah Life, for coming out today and supporting. Amen. 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 Thank you, young people. Thank you, young people. You did excellent today. Amen. Be ready next month. Be ready next month. We're gonna get y'all going back every month again. Amen. Amen. So be ready. I put the work on you guys, huh? Amen. Be ready. But every month. Amen. And then we have some other ministers minister once a month as well. Uplift the hands, let the words of my mouth, meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer, in Jesus' name, amen. Be blessed.